Well, good morning. It's Friday. It's a beautiful, beautiful day here, summer day, not a cloud in the sky. We had a tremendous rainstorm last night and really cleaned up the air. Straighten that a little bit. There you go. I'm over at the Jupiter Inlet. This boat right in front of us is fishing for snook. And we've got some people out here doing a little walking for exercise. So I thought I'd do a driving tour for you. We'll leave the inlet. We'll go over and go through Du Bois Park and then go on down to the Juno Pier where I'm going to spend a couple hours relaxing. So let's head out. So this is the Jupiter Inlet, straight ahead where that woman is walking the dog, and that anchor. That anchor is off the Jupiter Beach Wreck, the San Miguel. And that pathway there leads over to Du Bois Park. We'll be there in just a minute. And this, what you see up ahead here, that's the lagoon in the back of Du Bois. That's actually the original Jupiter Inlet. Before they dug the current one in the 1920s, this is how the ocean worked its way back into the what was the Jupiter River. Turn into Jupiter Beach Park here. Let you see this. Okay, so here we're going to head back out toward A1A, but we're going to turn down into Du Bois Park, and I'll let you see that. Du Bois family is one of our oldest pioneer families. They had a house here. You'll see the historic Du Bois house up on the what was an Indian midden, or a spot where they used to dispose of their oyster shells and things like that. Okay, so now we're on the other side of the Du Bois Lagoon. It's a great place for families to come and play. This will be packed with kids later today. And there's the bridge going over, back over to the Jupiter Inlet. Right there, turn the car a little bit so you can see it. Right there is the historic Du Bois Pioneer House, built up on, as I said, it's called an Indian Midden. It's an ancient shell mound built by the Yaga Indians. That house is open for tours. I'll stop here for a second, let you see. There goes a boat out the Jupiter Inlet. Okay, so now we're at okay, so this is A1A in Florida and probably most of the coastal United States. A1A is the road that runs right along the beach. US 1 could also be A1A, but most of the time US 1 is a few blocks in and A1A is just the beach road. When the beach road comes to an inlet and goes over the inlet, they has to merge with US 1, but this is a really popular spot in Jupiter on the weekends. It's full of people that riding those high-speed bicycles, large groups of them. They ride up on Jupiter Island. And it's also a favorite spot for runners. So this is Indian Town Road. Now I'm going to turn into Carlin Park, because it's part of the trip down to the pier. We've got our historic Civic Center in here and the Lazy Loggerhead Cafe. There was town authorities tried to destroy the Civic Center, and there was such an outcry from the population that they left it alone. They did manage to cut down one of the most beautiful trees here. Big, beautiful Australian pine. It had a trunk, must have had a 6-foot diameter on it. Well, I'm glad to see it's survived the government onslaught some more. So this is Carlin Park. This would be the beach over on this side. We've got baseball fields here, and there's another side to Carlin Park across the way. I'm not going to go over there, but there's an amphitheater and a jogging park and some tennis courts and things like that. There's pavilion's right here, right on the beach. We've had many a family gathering here in the 30 years I've lived in Jupiter. So we'll go back out here, and when I stop at this stop sign, I'll show you. That's the other side of Carlin Park. We're going to continue along A1A. We call it the beach road here. And now we're turning and we're going to be running right along the beach. It's about 3 miles down to the pier. Now there are crossovers or walkovers to the beach with showers and so on, and they're numbered. Let's see if we can see one here for you. Here's one. Here's 57. So the numbers are getting smaller that way, and people generally say where they're going to be at the beach. They're going to be a crossover, such and such. The kite boarders and windsurfers and all are down at number 33. Now up here on the left is the Jupiter Reef Club. This used to be a kind of a wild bar called the Ranch. That's it right there with the blue roof. You can see the American flag is very still. The condos on the right are million-dollar oceanfront condos. Tomorrow on Saturday, this will be packed. You won't be able to find a parking space, and there'll be lots and lots of people out walking. Now, this section is all dog friendly, so lots and lots of people have their dogs over here tomorrow. The only section you can't take your dog, some guy's surveying. The only place you can't take your dog is where there are guarded areas, so that would be Carlin Park and down right at the pier where I'm going today. So there's not a whole lot to see and talk about here, but if you're enjoying these driving tours, be sure and check out the playlist I have called Driving Tours, strangely enough. And I've also got some walking tours on there. I just posted 3 new driving tours. I did Miami, Biscayne Boulevard from 151st down to the Miami River. I did Brickell Avenue until the rain came. And then I did Old Coconut Grove and Old Cutler Road all the way down to Homestead. It's about 45 minutes long, but that's one of the most beautiful highways in Miami. So you might check that out. Yeah, if you have a chance to subscribe, I'd really appreciate it. Helps out the channel a lot. And if you can give me a thumbs up too, that helps Google spread the videos around so more people can enjoy them. And as I'm so fond of saying, anybody that can live in Jupiter does, and you can see why. It's just absolutely beautiful here. So I'm going to pull in up here at the park and go over to the pier. It's my favorite spot. If you want to go right on the beach, I can't take that sun anymore. When I was a kid, I could, but I can't anymore. So I go under the pier where it's 100% shade until right at the middle of the day where the sun is directly overhead and shines down through the planks on the pier. But anyway, I've got a couple of 3 hours here of 100% shade. There's not much breeze today, but the wind has been from the west for the past 2 days, so it's probably really, really clear and calm. So until the next video, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.